Some nights are just pitch black, without stars, and without sleep. Dirty nights clinging to you like tar. Like this one night, back in 1938. Boston. The Great Depression tsunami was just sweeping over what was left of America. Misery, hunger, despair. Times are hard, they said. Times were worse than hard. And the bar was about to close. As far as I was concerned, this was just another intoxicated day drawing to an end. If only I knew. The shock was still echoing in my bones, as the image of that girl coming out of nowhere surged back in my mind. Did I hit her? Was she dead? I couldn't remember. Thoughts were spinning in my head. I hope I didn't run her over. I hope she's still alive. Then, the pain. The terrible pain on my side. And this question. Where am I? trying to collect my thoughts, but the intense pain was scattering them like a bunch of dead birds. My fear of being wounded changed into an obsession. Was I about to die? I was all alone, with my pain growing and some nausea starting up. Don't stop. Think quick. Think well. It was just an accident. It happens. The girl must have made it out alive. I had to make it out alive, too. Feeling I was about to desecrate a sanctuary, to open the door to a world I didn't belong to. But whoever lived in there, they would understand. I needed help. Anyone would understand that. Getting somewhere safe. That's all that mattered. As the doors opened, The mansion seemed to react to my presence. There was a smell, like a cornered animal. The smell of fear. And yet, I entered the place because I had no choice. I was praying to find a phone or some help. I didn't even bother wondering what happened to prayers when they reached the wrong door.